In this short video, we are going to have a look at WireGuard and a new feature that is coming with 1.14, a feature you can already test with our snapshot versions, snapshot releases. And in with this new feature, what we can do is actually encrypt the traffic between hosts instead of just between pods. And we are also removing some of the restrictions that existed with WireGuard. So if we look back at version 1.10, that was a couple of years ago now, and that was when we introduced WireGuard support. And that was essentially the ability to provide encryption of traffic between pods, between Cilium managed pods, through a secure WireGuard tunnel. And this was an alternative to the transparent encryption method that was available with IPsec. I've already covered WireGuard and IPsec in a different video. There's also a tutorial on isurveillance.com. And we also have a lab available for you to try both features. But what I wanted to highlight is a couple of the limitations we had at the time, where we couldn't do host-to-host or pod-to-host encryption. And also, we didn't support layer 7 policy at the time. And as you can see here, we said we will add this in an upcoming Cilium release. And the good news is that it's coming with 1.14. So you can already test this with 1.14.0 snapshot 0. And what you'll see is that the whole WireGuard integration in the data path has been changed to support node-to-node encryption. And also what you can see here is in 1.13 and before, what we had is a number of limitations. We didn't support host-level encryption, and we didn't support layer 7 policy enforcement and visibility. And actually, if you look at the new documents, you can see that both these lines are removed because that's added in 1.14 and beyond. You will be, again, I'll put the links of in the description of this video, but we now support node-to-node encryption and host-to-node encryption and layer 7 network policies. Now let's have a look at a demo. So first, let's look back at Cilium before version 1.14, and I'm actually using the lab, which lets you test transparent encryption with IPsec and WireGuard. So let's install Cilium with WireGuard. So I'm just installing version 1.12. It only takes a minute or so, but what you'll notice is in 1.12, when we enable WireGuard, you can see that the YAML 7 proxy is disabled due to WireGuard encryption. It just wasn't compatible. Let's just check the Cilium status, and it's up and running. Now we're just going to have a quick look, make sure everything is set up correctly, and we're going to just go on the agent and just verify that WireGuard is encrypted. And you can see as well that with WireGuard we use tunnels, and the tunnel interface is this one here. And you can see as well the port number and that we're pairing with the other nodes here. Now again, we're still using version 1.12. So what we're going to do is quickly look at the traffic on the WireGuard 0 interface. Right, so I'm just installed TCP dump and just going to listen for traffic. And as you can see, by default, there's nothing whatsoever, no traffic. Even when I go, let's go here on this terminal, and we're going to go and connect to the agent, and we are going to do Cilium connectivity, like a health check. Which essentially is kind of a host-to-host connectivity test, and as you can see right now, it's happening, but still there's no traffic being sent on the WireGuard interface. But we do have some connectivity between hosts, right? So even when I run a Cilium Health ping, again, it's okay. But there's still no traffic on the WireGuard interface. It's only when I start actively doing some pod-to-pod tests that you will see some traffic being sent, right? So what we're doing, just to validate that traffic is being sent across the WireGuard interface, is let's deploy a couple of pods. And what I'm making sure is I pin them to two different nodes to make sure that they are manually, statically on different nodes. And we'll, once as soon as they're ready, go. Let's just get the IP. And I can see now that the WireGuard is seeing the node as a pod-to-pod traffic, which again has been working for a little while. That's great. But what we are going to see with 1.14 is node-to-node traffic. Now let's try 1.14 snapshot 0 and verify that traffic between nodes is now encrypted when we enable WireGuard. So what I'm doing first is adding the Helm, the Cilium repo, and then I'm going to enable encryption, WireGuard encryption, and node encryption. And let's just wait until Cilium is up and running. Perfect, and we are up and running. And we're going to run the same test we did earlier. So let's get onto the Cilium agent. And let's install TCP dump again. And let's start listening on the WireGuard interface. Now, you can already see traffic being sent. So what is happening? Well, you're going to see that we see traffic, regular traffic of a port 4240, which is the health check port that is used during the Cilium connectivity, the Cilium health check. We can also see pings, again, between the different nodes, right? 172.18.0.5, if I go in. That's the IP addresses between CAN worker 2 and CAN worker 3. Right? So you can see again that traffic is being encrypted between your two nodes as it's go through the WireGuard interface. Again, you can see this one, as mentioned before, the traffic to port 4240. If we check the documentation, you can actually see that the Cilium Health requires port TCP 4240, for all the nodes for the Cilium health monitoring. And as you can see, this is what this traffic is also being encrypted between the nodes. So that was just a really quick demo. Again, that's the idea around transparent encryption is that you don't have to think about it. It's just done for you, especially with WireGuard. You don't have to manage the keys. You don't have to rotate the keys. It's all done for you. And now with just an additional flag in your Cilium configuration, you can also enable node-to-node encryption. And that's it. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.